Hello everybody, so through this session we will continue our chapter The Beggar of Supplementary Reader Movements Only. So as we saw in the first part of video lecture that there is a beggar who used to create stories for asking money from people. He used to cheat people, and thing is that he was earlier working in a Russian choir as a singer, but because of his drinking habit he was thrown out of the band, and then he did not have any work and he started asking money only, started begging only. So he used to create stories. Sometimes he used to tell that he was a student who was expelled from the school, or other time he used to tell that he was a teacher, working as a teacher 8 years in a village, and then he lost his job and then he did not have any work. So such type of story he used to make. So one day, as he was asking only, he was attracting people's attention towards him. An advocate only named Sergi passed from there, and he recognized that fellow, that he was the same fellow who was day before yesterday in Sarvodaya Street also, and he had helped him that time. So when he saw this beggar again at another place with another story, he caught him and he threatened him to give him to police only. And when he asked, when the beggar asked that he did not have any option, then Sergi the advocate offered him some work of wood chopping only. So he went to his house and got some money for wood chopping, and at that point Sergi told his cook Olga, the lady, that if he wanted, the beggar wanted, he could come every month back and do some work in the house, and they would provide him money, they would provide him work also, and then they would pay him also. So after that, this beggar, he used to come regularly every month, and every time he used to come he would get half a ruble, although he was hardly able to stand on his legs because he used to drink much, whatever money he used to get. But then he used to be there regularly, and every time he used to be there, he was given some work, sometimes clearing of the snow, shoveling of snow means clearing of the snow from the yard, sometimes putting the woodshed in order, keeping the woods in order, sometimes the work of beating the dust from the mattresses, from the clothes, from the beddings. So every time he used to get some 20 to 40 kopecks, and one time he got a pair of trousers also, which Sergi's old trousers, so he gave him that also. So Sergi called him once when he was shifting his house also to another place, so he called him for packing another works also. So that time also the beggar came there, and this time he was sober, he was not drunk, but that time he was gloomy, sad, and he was totally silent. He did not do any work, he hardly touched any furniture, means he did not do any packing work, he did not help in shifting even, nothing he did do. So at the end of the work, however, Sergi was happy. So Sergi called him and talking about why he was happy, because he found that the beggar was changed, he was not drunk. So he called him and he gave him a ruble that day, and he told that he was happy that he was sober that day and that he did not have any objection in working. And then that time Sergi asked him his name also. So the first time he told, the beggar told that his name was Lashkov. So he said that Sergi told him that as Lashkov was now clean, he had left his habit of drinking also, so he could be given some cleaner work also. So he asked him if he could write, if he knew writing also, how to write. So Lashkov told definitely he could write also. Then Sergi gave him a letter also and told him that took this letter to one of his friend only next day, and he would give him some writing copying work only, and he wished him well done, good luck also, and told him that he should work hard and he should not drink ever in future also, and remember his words. So that day Sergi, he was happy also that he has put some person on a right track. He shook hands also with him. So Lashkov took the letter, and after that he did not come back in the yard, and definitely he went to the person to whom Sergi has recommended him. So 2 years passed, and one evening Sergi was standing at the ticket window of a theater paying for his seat, and he noticed a little man just beside him by his side only. He was also standing, he was also in the queue, in the line only. He also was standing there for buying the ticket, and this person was in good clothes, curly fur coat was worn, and a sealskin cap was also on his head. So this little fellow asked the ticket seller that he should give him a ticket for the balcony in the gallery only, and then he paid the money in copper coins. So copper coins, poor people did not had copper coins. The story was written 20-30 years back, so Russia. So definitely that showed that he was rich enough now. So Sergi recognized that fellow, that was nobody else but this was his old wood chopper, and this was Lashkov only. So he recognized and he asked, Lashkov, was that you only? And he recognized him. So he asked how he was and what he was doing, how was he doing, what work was he doing that time, where was he doing. So he told, Lashkov replied that he was fine and that he was a notary then in the court only, some writing work he used to do, and that he was paid 35 rubles a month, a salary also he used to get. So Sergi was happy for him, and he said that he was delighted, he was so much happy for him that he was now changed and he got success also in his life. And he told that Lashkov, if you remember, Sergi told that he was his godson. He was kind of adopted only. He picked him up from the road, he motivated him and he changed his life, and that he had put him on the right track. So Lashkov also thanked him, and he told that yes, thanks for everything, whatever he had done for him. And he told that if he had not asked him to work that day, if he had not taken him that day from the road to his home only, then in that case till that day he must have been making false stories related that he was a student only or he was a village school teacher only, and he must have been begging only continued till that day. But just coming to the protection of Sergi only, his life was changed, and then he thanked him again. But then he said that God bless that noble woman of yours, that cook of yours only, who spoke finally then, and that he was indebted to her also. He was so thankful to her also, and if he speaks strictly to tell the truth only, actually it was his cook Olga only, because of whom his life was changed and who has saved his life. So Sergi was totally confused, and he told that how was that. He was thinking that all help was done by him only, money he used to provide only. So, and all the credit is given to cook Olga only. How? So he asked, why are you saying so? So he told that when he came to his house that day for chopping the wood, that lady used to continuously abuse him, scold him, and she used to call him sot. Sot means drunkard. And she used to say that he was a miserable creature and that he would ruin, he would be destroyed, and he would die. If he would continue drinking like that, he would die soon, and that there is nothing for him in the world. He is totally ruined. And then she used to curse him continuously, but then she used to cry also for him. She used to feel so bad for him. And then he told, the most important thing is that he did not cut a single piece of wood for him. All the wood was chopped by Olga the cook only. He did not do anything. He didn't do any work there. So she used to tell Sergi that the wood have been chopped, but actually she used to cut the wood herself, and then money she used to provide to this beggar. And he told that actually he also did not know why her such behavior changed her, but all in all, just because of this kind of behavior towards him, he was now changed. He left drinking, and that's all. So he said that whatever he was there that time, that was just because of Olga the cook only. So actually he told that she was the lady who has put him on the right track. After that, Lashkov bade him goodbye and went away from there. So we got the message here that no matter if we are rich or not, one should have the zeal, one should have the desire to help others. And it's not only money that we can help. We can help others by our good deeds also. We can help others by our talking about wishes also. So that was all about the chapter The Beggar by Anton Chekhov, which was actually about a beggar, Lashkov, and who was a drunkard only and who was thrown out of his job, started begging also, but because of the goodness of a lady, Olga, whose life was later on changed. So that's all for now. Thank you.